This story is a lot like the enzymes bubbling in this mixture. A small concentration with a lot of potential for change.
In the end, everything we're doing will help other people. We're trying to produce new treatments for diseases that currently have no treatments, and also possibly prevent drug shortages.
This is the Bioprocess Engineering Program at East Carolina University. Bioprocess engineering, by the way, is the creation of biological products using live organisms and enzymes rather than organic and inorganic chemicals. Vaccines are a good example. So are alternative fuels, such as ethanol. Because some products just can't be made using traditional chemical engineering, bioprocess engineers utilize the natural molecular machinery of cells, or enzymes, and then design and develop the equipment and the processes to create products.
And so we use their molecular machinery, their resources, almost like microscopic bioreactors. So we use them as these organisms to produce these products for us. Now, these kinds of products are proteins like insulin and vaccines and other biotherapeutics, things that need to be injected that cannot be ingested, otherwise they would be degraded in the digestive tract.
It's a small program, but it's not unique. Many of North Carolina's universities and community colleges offer programs that feature bioprocess engineering. And there's good reason. More than 600 biotech companies call North Carolina home. Those firms employ more than 61,000 workers. It's the third highest biotech concentration in the nation. But ECU's students are working on more than just the typical classroom project.
It's actually a really hard project because this has actually never been done before. There's no tolerogenic vaccine on the market, so we kind of had to start from scratch. We had to do a lot of basic research, and that's why it's taking so long in the like preliminary stage before we can get into lab, because we do have to come up with all the steps of how we're going to make this, how we're going to actually grow it, how are we going to get the protein, how are we going to inject it into people, how long it's going to last, if it's going to last, that kind of thing.
ECU students are working with the Brody School of Medicine at ECU to develop a manufacturing process for a new vaccine. There's also a multi-year contract with a local biomedical device company to develop a new compound that can be used in medicines. That out-of-the-box thinking that students bring to the project helps lead to discoveries.
They come from it from, I don't know what I know, I don't know what I need to know, and I'm going to find out all the information that I need to solve this problem. So they work in teams, and so they all kind of gel together, so to speak, and make these things happen. Do they run into some bumps? Absolutely. But they do take a fresh approach, like you mentioned, and they also look at it as an opportunity that they get to utilize all of the information, their experience, their practice from their curriculum, and now let's put it to something that somebody really needs. Somebody is essentially put you to the task.
In fact, one of those bumps was hit just recently, and it was a big bump. How close are you? Because you've been working on this for a while.
We've been pretty close until about last week when we found out one of our ingredients that we need has been stopped being made. So we're going to have to somewhat redesign or force an ingredient to work properly. And in doing that, we're uncertain right now.
But it was also a valuable lesson. Even out-of-the-box thinking has its limits.
It's stressful because having to work with real-world companies rather than schoolwork is very different and taxing, because we have to meet their deadlines and expectations. So it's very different, but overall it is fun. This is what we're going to school for, so of course we'd enjoy it.